Hey guys, Tristan here, Fidelity TV. Hope you're doing good. This is a dumbbell workout to be done at home. All it requires is a pair of dumbbells. So let's get some water, we'll get our workout gear, and I will take you through it. See you inside. Okay guys, welcome. Now, I hope you're all doing well first and foremost, you and your family, friends. When this is being recorded, it's obviously quarantine time. I'm taking a break from my quarantine and teaching my children and all that stuff to have a micro workout. Now these come under the micro workout brand. Before I get into it, however, as you probably know, with my other workouts, with all of them, the two blocks, we have the introduction section, which I'm gonna try to keep them as short as I can, but this requires a bit of a chit chat to go through it. So if you want to straight to the workout you've been in before, just forward one through to where you see the session timer bar pop up above my head. That's when you know the workout's gonna start. However, to start with here, I want to just let you know that micro workouts, these I'm putting together throughout this quarantine period, just so we can all have something really, really quick that to have a break from our crazy days, our crazy lockdown and quarantine, we can go and do these. Now, most of them I think are body weight, but of course I'm gonna do some as well where we're using weights. This is under the micro workouts, you know, playlist, but if you wanna make it into a longer workout, you certainly can just add in a second or even a third circuit of this, right? Because it's gonna be a circuit format. Next, weight selection. Typically, for each of these exercises, we would all probably lift different weights. However, because it's kind of like a metabolic circuit, where we're gonna go through one after the other, we're gonna stick with a weight. Hear that there? The zombie apocalypse. You know, I don't know what the hell that is. Oh my God. Anyhow, we're gonna stick with the same weights throughout. These are not gonna, you're not gonna choose the heaviest weight you normally would. I'm going with the 25 pounder. That's gonna be good because we're doing a higher rep count, and if you do actually add second and third circuits, the weight is gonna feel heavier and heavier. All right, just bear that in mind. When you choose a weight, choose something I would say probably for, let's say for a shoulder press, you could do 12 reps without feeling like it's over the top. If you get to the point where you're struggling, your form's starting to suffer, drop the weight down because the very nature of this circuit means that going through it, it becomes very demanding, all right? So I'm using 25s for this, I'm using 25s for every single exercise. Okay, as you can see here, we've got a little kind of prep section here. We're not doing any timing on this one as we've done some of the other micro workouts. What we're doing is rep count. Everything is 12 reps, unless I decide I might change it later on, I don't know. If you do a second and a third circuit, second circuit, when you go to 15, third, maybe drop the weights, do 20 reps for everything. Or if you really wanted to come back and do this again in a different way, you could do 20 reps for everything. Second circuit, 15, third, 12, that kind of thing. Or just do 12 every single circuit. But there's ways you can change it according to what you feel like. Start here with the prep, then we've got working the lower body here with goblet dumbbell squats. We're then gonna kind of hammer the chest with like a back-to-back floor flies and then push-ups, all right? Next, we're gonna go into some stiff leg deadlift combo or combo exercise there. We're gonna superset the arms, hammer curls and kickbacks, and then we'll finish with the dumbbell push crunch. So we're gonna hit the whole body, hence the black sweatbands. I'm gonna have some water, get ready, and then we'll go through it. So, hope you're ready, let's have some fun. Okay guys, go into a warm up or prep. Jumping jacks first, let's do, I don't know, 20 of them. Soft landing, nothing crazy. Oh God, I've lost count already. Never mind. Just get to about there, okay. Get the legs up a bit, make some ankle rolls. Just loosen that joint up. Okay. And I've got on here huggers. What I do is almost all the time because I think it's great and I really do like to loosen up my chest and my shoulders. So going over and under. And maybe some in front. So just to loosen up that area. Okay. Just to get the point where I feel ready. Now a lot of times you might do much more intense warm-up perhaps, but I don't think we need it for this, so I'm good to go. Let's work through it. Goblet, dumbbell squat. I'm gonna do it with a high grip up here. 12 reps, 3, 2, 1, let's go. Let's sit onto our heels, putting our hips down. Cool, 10, 11,
12. Okay.
We're going through these exercises pretty quick, so come down here. Floor flies. If you have a bench, no, you could use that, of course. I'm coming down here. Have the weights, bring them in. All I'm doing is coming up, and then to my arms, hitting the floor, squeeze at the top. Down. If I miss 12 reps, because I'm talking to you, my apologies. Do 12. Up there. I'm squeezing that chest. And one thing again, on the way down, on negative, try and go a little bit slower. Probably at 2 to squeeze. 1, 2, 3, feel the tension, and up again. Okay, right. Push-ups on the dumbbells. I say use a dumbbell just because, for me, it makes my wrists feel more comfortable than doing that, but whatever's best for you. Maybe your fists, that's something you like, whatever. Or the little handle things, you know, those push-up, perfect push-up things, or anything like that. But let's make sure on this, we come down, our chest actually goes between the dumbbells and touches the floor, okay? So 12 of these. Try and do there is in terms of hand placement, I'm going a little bit wider, okay, just so I've got the room for my chest to come through there. Well, in some of the other workouts, I do some close grip ones, which I really like for the triceps. All right, next one, stiff leg deadlift calf raise combo exercise. Stiff leg deadlift, for all intents and purposes, since we'll be doing this, we're here, coming down, pivoting from the waist, coming up. So we'll come down, up. Calf raise, down, calf raise, down, calf raise, down, pivot up the hamstrings, calf raise, okay? That calf raise, really squeeze at the top, kind of there, squeeze, down, slight bend the knees. Right, into hammer curls. Standard, upright one, we're not sitting down. Just, when I do curls, what I like to do, as long as the weight's not crazy, I put one foot behind the other. I just feel a bit more stable than if I'm just here, right? So a little bit like that. It's a kickback's next, but with this, again, speed. 2 seconds up, a little slower on the way down, okay? And try not to have your shoulders up here. Try to be more neutral and relaxed, okay? Kickbacks. Here, I do like these, I always like kickbacks. Except when I'm doing them, I try and keep the tension on the tricep, so by doing that, what means this, I'll come to there and back there. Instead of coming all the way back and relaxing, so I'm more like there. In. I'm a little bit faster. One more. Okay, into there now. What I'm doing in this position is I'm trying to always focus on
bend my knees slightly, keep my back as flat as possible, almost concave. And my elbows, I'm trying to push the tricep against the lat muscle to keep it somewhat stable, rather than being down here, like, you know, this sort of thing. You want to be locked in, then go for the squeeze, come to about there. All right, dumbbell, push, crunch. A little bit of core down here. I hold this like that, and just all I want to do is crunch up, looking up here. I'm not crunching up and over, it's up from the tension in the top part of the abs and down. Arms locked. And let's do 15. So that's 16. Okay, with that, of course, be sure you got a strong grip. Don't have it over your face. You know, that wouldn't be good. So strong grip over your chest. And what you find with that, the first few, you're getting the feel for that. You might well be tempted to kind of come up and go over. 3, 4, 5, 6, those reps. You feel like you can go up a little bit higher. And we'll try and just, it's not me a lot, it's minimal. But just try and go a little bit more, see more of a contraction on the upper abs. So, that there is the circuit. Now, if you're using it as a micro workout, job done. You can go back into quarantine, back home, whatever you're doing, get back in the game. However, if you want to do more, have a breather, probably 2 minutes, have some water, go through it a second time. Now, you'll know better than me right now whether you want to add a rep, whether the weight's too light, whether 2 circuits is great for you as opposed to 3. Whatever it may be, but give it a go, see how it works for you. I really hope it can help you right now in the current climate, and also when the quarantine and all that is over, fingers crossed, these are great quick workouts to do when you need to do some of the time saving, but can actually help you. So thanks so much for taking the time to watch. All the best, and I'll see you on the next one. Take care.